Hey everybody, how's it going? It's Ron with Ron's Computer Videos. Hey, I just wanted to share a project that I've been working on recently. I have this Apple desktop keyboard for quite a while. This is the ADB keyboard that was introduced with the SE and the Mac 2. Is basically as a follow-up to the original ADB keyboard that came with the Apple 2GS. Recently, I went through and did an indoor RetroBright on this, and man, it turned out great. All things considered, at least now the case plastics and stuff match the keycaps and all. This keyboard's kind of unique. The spacebar and the case are made of the same plastic. I think all the rest of the keys are made of ABS, so they don't have the issue with turning all dingy, kind of like the other stuff does. But anyway, this turned out really great. That now I want to do another cooler keyboard. Yep, the Apple adjustable keyboard coming up next on my next indoor RetroBright project. We'll see how it goes. All right, we've got all of our parts together. This stuff here, we can just drop directly in the tank. And you can see they're not all that bad. It could use a little bit of love, but so we'll definitely do that. All of these things need a good scrub. You can definitely see, that key's got some problems. We'll figure out what's going on with that here in a minute. But we're gonna have to pull all these keys, go ahead and disassemble the keyboard cases, and then figure out how to best get these in. On the adjustable part of the adjustable keyboard, this needs to be greased, and we gotta pull all these little specialty buttons and stuff out too, so that way that we can get those cleaned up. Every one of these keys needs a little bit of TLC. If you remember, just recently in a short, replaced this keyboard came from Eric John Miller. Very kind of him to donate this to the channel. So I'm gonna go ahead and it'll probably play in fast motion, so you don't have to like watch the whole thing. But I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna pull all these keycaps and get this stuff ready to go. So cue the retro towel. All right, let's get her disassembled. Thank you. have our keycaps pulled. We've got everything in a nice little pile. I'll clean these up by hand, but real fast, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put all of our plastics in the vat and get them working, because it takes several days if you do the submersion version of retr0bright. So I'm going to go ahead and get that going, and I'll meet you right back here. Oh my gosh, this was so much work. This was so much more work than I thought it would be. And that little part where I forgot the order in which the cables all plugged together really set me back quite a while I just kind of sat there and experimented with things. But all in all, I got everything to go back together pretty much exactly how it was. I would say probably the biggest thing I was disappointed in the project was how well the spacebar responded to the Submersion RetroBright. I may just put this keyboard out in the sun one day and just see if I can brighten that up a tiny bit more. But generally speaking, I think it looks all right. It's in much better shape than it was to begin with. It's still not a great keyboard. They kind of have a bad rep, and I know that in the past a lot of people had to send them off for repairs multiple times, so that's probably why there's so few surviving examples today. But it's just sort of a neat thing, and I think if you can work with it and adjust it and kind of figure out where your sweet spot is, the Apple adjustable keyboard's probably not a bad thing to add to your collection. In any case, thanks for watching, everybody. Have a wonderful evening. And as I always say, Apple II forever.